We took 600 villages across Bangladesh, enrolling nearly 350,000 adults. And half of them were assigned to our mask promotion intervention. And within this, we included many different types of promotion activities, from text messaging reminders to public signage about the importance of wearing masks. And at the end of this, when we did our analysis, we found that in spite of all of the different types of activities that we conducted, there were only four interventions that seemed to really have an impact on improving mask wearing. And we refer to these as the norm set of interventions. So N stands for no cost masks. We distributed either surgical or cloth masks at the household level. We also provided them in public spaces like markets if people didn't have masks. The O refers to offering information. And this is something that we did while we were distributing the masks. We also showed videos to the participants from key leaders such as the Prime Minister of Bangladesh, Sheikh Hasina, or the lead cricket player, or the lead imam, all of them promoting masks. And these were just short video clips demonstrating that these leaders felt that mask wearing was important. And then the R is for reinforcement. And this was conducted by having people actually walking through these public spaces, through markets, through other tea stalls and places where people congregate, reminding them the importance of wearing masks and providing the masks if they didn't have one. And then the last part, M, is modeling. And this is having local leaders also be engaged in the promotion and themselves wearing masks and supporting the wearing of masks. And we found it was just these four things that were really effective in increasing mask wearing, which is really pretty remarkable considering that we didn't use any mask mandates or heavy-handed punishments for people not wearing masks, but we really tried to do it as an encouragement. And we were able to observe that we had a 29 percentage point increase in the villages that received this intervention. So that was significant. It was actually a tripling from the baseline that we saw. The second part of the intervention then was to measure what effect this had on COVID-19. And we did this by asking the participants over the course of the study if they had any symptoms, such as symptoms consistent with COVID-19, respiratory symptoms, gastrointestinal symptoms. And those who had symptoms that were consistent with COVID-19, we then collected their blood at the end of the study and we tested it for antibodies against the SARS-CoV-2 virus. And what we found from this was that with a 29 percentage point increase in mask wearing, we were able to reduce COVID-19 cases by 9%. And this effect was primarily driven by the surgical masks. When we looked at just the surgical masks by themselves, we found that they were 11% effective at reducing COVID-19 cases. And furthermore, when we stratified this by different age groups, we found that there was an increasing effect with increasing age. So for people age 60 and above, we actually were able to reduce 35% of COVID-19 cases, which was pretty remarkable considering that this is such a high-risk group.
Put your mask on.
Certainly, rural Bangladesh is not the same as the Bay Area. There are many, many differences. But I think if anything, the Bay Area stands to see even more benefit from mask wearing. And the reason for this is because we spend a lot more time indoors than people do in rural Bangladesh, who are primarily outdoors in very well-ventilated spaces. And so in the Bay Area, as we transition back into offices, back into schools, we're going to be in higher risk environments where people are going to be in closer proximity. There may be recirculated air. We may not have the option to open windows, for example. And so we really do need to think about how we can make this transition as safe as possible. And so I think masks are going to be a really key strategy as a part of that, even in groups of people that are highly vaccinated, especially thinking about places where people may not be fully vaccinated, is even more imperative that we use this as a strategy. So, for example, in schools where most of the children are ineligible for the vaccine, but also in places of work where there may be other employees for whom they're unable to receive the vaccine or the vaccine may not be as effective, and thinking about how to protect the community at large as a real strategy to reduce the overall transmission of the virus.